girls, welcome back. So in this video, I'm sharing with you two of my favorite tips on how to get a flawless makeup application. Me and three of my good friends here on YouTube decided to get together and each share two of our favorite tips on just how to get flawless makeup. So we each picked our favorites and I can't wait to share mine with you. The girls that I collabed with are Missy, Brianna, and Chelsea. I'm gonna link each of their videos down below so that you can see their two top tips on how to get flawless makeup. So my first tip is to try mixing your foundation with a serum. So I love mixing my foundation with a serum on a daily basis because on a daily basis, my lifestyle just doesn't call for like full-on glam session makeup that looks like I'm about to go on a photo shoot. So my main objective on a daily basis is just to even out my skin tone, and mixing your foundation with a serum will just make it actually a lot more beneficial to your skin, and it will also thin it out enough so your makeup doesn't look so cakey. And I like mixing it with a serum versus say an SPF because that way I don't get so shiny throughout the day, and serums just have so many benefits in them. So it just thins it out and makes it more of a silky consistency, so it glides on your skin. So it basically turns your foundation into a treatment and keeps your skin looking like skin throughout the day. And I have it on right now, and now I'm gonna show you how I apply it. So of course you can use any serum, but I always have a ton of samples just that I get from different beauty subscriptions I'm subscribed to or from ordering beauty products and makeup online, and I always make a point to pick up different samples when I hit Sephora or Ulta. So I like to go through these when I'm mixing them in with my foundation. So before I apply the foundation serum mixture, I am going to go ahead and color correct any discoloration in my skin. So this is optional, but I do this because I have some discoloration in my skin that I don't want peeking through my foundation mixture. So under my eyes, around my nose, mouth, and chin, and of course any blemishes I may have. Now to mix up our foundation serum mixture, I'm just placing a little bit of my foundation, and it a little goes a long way. And I like to do a little bit more of my serum than I do the foundation. And here I'm mixing it up with a makeup spatula, but you can use anything like the back of a makeup brush or something like that. I like to get mine about this consistency, like a mousse consistency, but you can customize this however you like it, if you want it more thin or a little thicker. So I'm gonna apply this with my beauty blender. And there's nothing different about the way it applies. It applies just like foundation. And you can see here, it still has plenty of coverage and just gives you a nice, fresh, healthy appearance to your skin. And my second tip is to try cream, blushes, and bronzers versus powder. And the reason why is because creams are going to blend and melt into your skin and foundation better than a powder will. And they actually look absolutely beautiful on fresh skin without any foundation at all on. So if you're just looking for like a little bit of bronzer or maybe some color to your cheeks and you don't have the time for foundation, creams are a great way to go. I don't know if you've ever tried to apply powder blush or bronzer when you don't have any foundation on. It just doesn't really sit well or blend well into the skin, but creams will. So starting out with my bronzer, I'm gonna apply this right where I would a contour powder. And even if I'm gonna do an all over bronzed look with this, I still start where my contour would be. That way, that's the deepest part of my bronze. And here I'm showing you the difference that that makes. I mean, just look how much better that makes my complexion look. And now I'm gonna finish the other side and also hit my forehead and my jawline. And now for cream blush, I like to apply cream blush with a foundation brush, and I start out by applying it to the apples of my cheeks and then blending back and downward right into my contour. And here's what one side looks like finished. And then to set the entire look, I'm applying setting powder. So I hope you enjoyed my top two tips on how to achieve a flawless makeup application. I picked those two because they're actually tips that I use on a daily basis, so I really wanted to share those with you. I hope you try them out, and I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to check out the description box for the other three videos. Chelsea, Brianna, and Missy are all sharing their top two flawless makeup application tips. And that way you get eight tips instead of just my two. So I hope you enjoyed this. And as always, if you have any questions for me, comment me down below. And I will see you girls in my next video. Bye.